Everyone, myself, M.A. Mahant, working in Computer Science and Engineering Department as an Assistant Professor in Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today we are discussing the topic Message Passing Approach in Distributed System. Learning outcomes. At the end of the session, students will be able to explain different techniques of message passing systems, identify different issues in message passing systems. Message passing. Message passing means transferring of data or messages from sender to receiver. There are two basic methods of information sharing. One is shared data approach, in which shared memory concept is used. Different processors which are connected in the communication network, they are using this shared memory in the shared data approach. The second one is message passing approach, in which the messages can be transferred from sender to receiver. A process is a program in execution. Two computers are communicating with each other. We mean that two processes, one running on each computer, are in communication with each other. Each computer of a distributed system may have a resource manager process to monitor the current status of usage of its local resources, and the resource manager of all the computers might communicate with each other from time to time to dynamically balance the system load among all the computers. Therefore, distributed operating system needs to provide inter-process mechanisms to facilitate such communication activities. This is the diagram of two inter-process communication paradigms. In figure A, the shared data approach can be shown, where processes P1 and P2 are sharing the shared common memory. In figure B, the message passing approach can be shown, where process P1 will be sending the message to process P2, and process P2 will be sending acknowledgement to process P1. In this way, the communication between two processes can be shown in the message passing approach. Message passing approach. Actually, in this message passing approach, information is copied from sender address space to receiver's address space. Distributed system uses message-based inter-process communication, IPC, for most applications. IPC provides a set of message-based IPC protocol that hides the heterogeneous platforms. Two primitives, send and receive, is used by the IPC. Two higher-level IPC systems are RPC and DSM. Here, the meaning of DSM. In computer science, distributed shared memory is a form of memory architecture where physically separated memories can be addressed as one logically shared address space. A distributed shared memory system implements the shared memory model on a physically distributed memory system. The desired features of message passing approach: simplicity, uniform semantics, efficiency, reliability, flexibility, and portability. Now we are going to see all the features one by one. Simplicity. Message passing system is simple and easy to use. There is use of clean and simple semantics of IPC protocol and its primitives. Means in the message passing system is very simple and easy to use, and it is user friendly, and it is independent of heterogeneity. Actually, heterogeneity means different computers having different operating system like Windows, Linux, or Macintosh, etc. So message passing system having one kind of compatibility so that it will run on all the machines, independent of underlying network and its aspect. I mean, different machines having different hardware configuration and software configuration, and having the part of different network. So message passing approach supports all kinds of networks and all kinds of configurations. Uniform semantics. Two types of IPC. One is local communication, means communication between two processes on same machine. And second one, remote communication, means communication of two processes on different machines. Semantics of remote communication should be as close as possible to those of local communication. Same system call can be used for local as well as remote communication. Efficiency. Now, in efficiency, we are reducing the number of message exchange per user, avoiding the cost of establishing and terminating connections with the same process for every message, so that it minimizes the cost of maintaining connections and use piggybacking techniques. So we are maintaining, once the connection established between the sender and receiver, number of messages can be passed from sender to receiver. So there is no necessary of establishing separate connection for every message passing. So this saves the cost of maintaining the connection. So in the context of computer science and digital communication, the piggybacking refers to a situation where an unauthorized party gains access to some system in connection with an authorized party. This can happen in several ways, including piggybacking on public wireless networks and piggybacking into a password protected systems. Next feature is reliability. So failure such as node crashes or communication link failure can occur. It intercepts the communication in progress. The messages can be lost. Lost messages handled by the acknowledgement and retransmission technique. Duplicate message handled by the sequence number two messages. So every message having the sequence number, so that we have to find the lost messages or retransmitted messages. Correctness. Feature related to IPC protocol for group communication. Issues related to correctness are atomicity, means apply to all or apply to none. Order delivery, means passing the message one after another. Survivability, messages will be delivered correctly in despite of partial failures. Means in survivability, there is partial failure, but the messages can be delivered successfully from sender to receiver. Flexibility. IPC primitives should be flexible so that user have choice to specify the type and levels of reliability. So here in flexibility, so many things in the user's hand, just like type and level of the reliability. Correctness requirement can be chosen. Their kind of synchronous or asynchronous communication can be chosen. Now next feature is security. In message passing system, provide a secure end-to-end communication. So authentication of receiver by the sender means sender has to check the proper receiver. Authentication of sender by receiver means receiver has to check the proper sender. Means here we are checking the authenticated sender and receivers in the security point of view. So for protecting the messages, we are applying encryption of messages. In this different encryption, decryption, security techniques are used for safe communication. So in this security feature, we are providing the data, security to the data and messages. Portability. Two different aspects. Message passing system itself portable means a new IPC facility, means inter-process communication facility, on another system constructed using basic design of an existing IPC. Applications written using primitives of IPC protocol should be portable of a new system, means needs to handle heterogeneity and hence uses external data representation format on computers of different architectures. Now we are going to see the structure of message. Here, the sender can send the message and receiver can be receive the message, but there is a specific format or structure of message. So here, fixed length header and data of varying size. So header consisting of three elements: address, sequence number, and structural information. So in this diagram, a typical message structure can be shown. So this is the fixed length header can be shown. Before this, variable size collection of data type. Then data in first column, data or pointer to the data can be shown. In structural information, the number of bytes and type of information can be provided. Then the sequence number can be written for every message. In addresses, the receiving process ID and sending process ID can be written. Pause the video and write the answer of the given question. What are the different issues in message passing system? important issues to be considered. First, we have to check who is the sender, who is the receiver, is there one or multiple receivers, is received message acknowledged, should sender wait for acknowledgement, what if node crash or communication link fails during transmission, if receiver does not accept the message, then it will be buffered or discarded. Now we are going to see the next concept, that is synchronization. Synchronization also occurs between the network nodes to ensure that data streams are received and transmitted correctly and to prevent data collision. It usually uses a clock signal transmitted in sequence with a data stream to maintain proper signal timing. There are two types of semantics used, blocking and non-blocking, in synchronization. In blocking semantics, blocking send is one of the semantic and blocking receive is another semantic. So in blocking send, the sending process blocked after execution of send until it receives the acknowledgement. In blocking receive, receiving process blocked after execution of receive until it receives a message. Synchronous communication, the non-blocking semantics. In non-blocking semantics, send, non-blocking send, the sending process continues its execution as soon as the message can be copied to sender's buffer. Non-blocking receive, the receiver process continues its execution after receiving message into its buffer. These are the references. Thank you.